Here at Opto 22, we get involved in some really exciting and compelling projects. I got an email one day, seemed a little bit vague, but looked like something that we might be interested in pursuing. Turns out that the project was to be a mission critical component on James Cameron's Deepsea Challenger. And when we found that out, we couldn't wait to get involved.
Just south of Guam, the Marianas Trench is a split between two tectonic plates. And then Challenger Deep is the deepest part of Mariana Trench.
I mean, think about it. Only 12 people have walked on the surface of the moon or been to the moon, yet we've only had two that have gone down to the deepest part of the world's oceans. And it was clear that this application had a lot of communications in it. There was tons and tons of Modbus systems and other ancillary products that were connected in this sub. And I thought, this is actually perfect for the type of projects that we're involved in. And I also knew that we had the right guy who was perfect.
Bob and Benson called me into the office and said, how would you like to go to Australia for 2 weeks, work on a top secret project? To be honest, at that stage, I had no idea what I was getting into. I mean, I knew it was a submarine, but I didn't understand, you know, just the historic significance of it.
Literally in 2 days' time, we packed together everything we thought he would need and put him on an airplane heading for Sydney.
I got off the airplane, walked into a nondescript factory in the Sydney suburbs. Very short order, I'd met both James Cameron and Ron Allam, the co-designer of the submersible. And the team that Jim and Ron assembled didn't have any submersible experience. And they did that deliberately because they wanted to bring fresh ideas and fresh methodology and engineering practices to this solution. And it really worked well because we ended up with a submersible that was leading edge, state of the art, a lot of groundbreaking technologies, the batteries and the lighting systems, the thrusters. Obviously I was focused on the control system, but the control system was on a submersible that was going to be crushed by the weight of the world's ocean.
The amount of pressure down there is unfathomable. And in this case, we're talking about 7 miles deep. We're at 16,000 pounds of pressure per square inch.
And everything we were building outside the sphere had to handle that sort of pressure.
That makes this type of expedition exceedingly difficult to do. And when you're down there, nothing can go wrong.
There were two main criteria for the control system. It had to take up as small a space as possible, and Opto needed to be able to communicate easily and freely with all those different systems all at the same time. As my 2 weeks drew to a close at the factory, I was approached by the team leader and asked if I would join the team on the expedition. So your typical day started usually around 6, 6:15 a.m, get some breakfast in, and there was an engineering meeting on the bridge every day, 7 a.m. without fail, to go over the day's activities. Once the meeting was over, it was all hands on deck, literally, as we prepped the sub to get it ready for that day's repairs or for that day's dive. As the dive program progressed, and each dive was deeper than the previous, different science was being done and different setups were being able to be tested for the first time on the submersible. So there were constant changes to the control system to adapt to this deeper dive program. So on the final dive, when Jim got to the bottom, it looked like he was on the moon. It just looked like there was just nothing, just endless fine silt. But after he took the samples and came back up and they were analyzed, turns out to be teeming with life. Ron and Jim assembled a really diverse team, and it brought a lot of fresh ideas to the problems of building a full ocean depth submersible, and it worked spectacularly. Deepsea Challenger went down and back in record time, and it was incredible that Opto was part of the machine, part of the process that got Jim there and back safely.